If you're trying to run a business, wouldn't it be great if you had a checklist that could help you know exactly what to do to get the best SEO action on your website? A checklist covering all the basic things you need to do so that you can be shown in the search engines, on Google Maps, and in effect get more traffic in the coming year. And of course, having this SEO checklist will give you confidence and help you see greater results in Google as you rank higher and get more clients. So as I go through this checklist, I'm going to show you step by step what you need to do so that you can feel confident to know how to go about it. Also, look out for those videos that I'm going to show you where you can get a bit more depth on a separate video. But you'll need to watch this video all the way through first of all before you go to those other videos. And so you don't lose this video, make sure you subscribe and give it a like, maybe even give it a favorite if it's one you're going to come back to. How many SEO tutorials presume you know everything? Well, this is going to presume you're coming in on a basic level of understanding. Now, if you've got any questions, then put them in the comments below and I'll do my best to give you answers as well. I'm going to show you how to do it, not tell you what to do. So here on the checklist, we're going to work through these basic areas that are going to help you get more traffic. The first one, as you can see here, is keywords. So what do we know about keywords? Search engines are far more intelligent than they used to be. So they understand phrases and they understand various adaptations of keywords too. So when you write an article, you may want to know what your keywords are. You may want to do some research. I'll show you in a moment how to do that. But first of all, just focus on writing for the customer, but have in the back of your head the keyword or the key phrases that you're searching for. So why do you need keywords? Well, because they're the very words that people are using in the search engines to find an article or your business. So here we have Neil Patel's Uber Suggest. And if I now put in here a keyword, so like if I'm a plumber and I can choose a country, click search. And this is a free tool. And you can now see these are the very things that people are putting in the search engine. So this is giving you keywords to look for. So plumber merchants near me might be a key phrase you use. Say plumber in my area. If you notice a plumber company, plumber for a dishwasher. And you can get these results. This shows you the volume as well. So if it's a lot of people searching for it, this also shows you the CPC, which in effect is saying what people are paying for it. And the reason this is important is this gives you a clue as to how lucrative that key phrase is. So plumbers near me, people are paying for this. Plumbers are paying for this. And $7.45 for a plumber in London. So again, we can see it's got more of a lucrative, particularly when you have the area. And that's why local search engine ranking is so valuable, because people are paying a premium to have the area. Plumber in my area, $4.49. And then this tells you how difficult it is. So you're looking for green ones, really, unless you've got a very authoritative website. So if you notice here, Plumber London is still possible. It's green, it's still possible for you to get hold of that. So once you've then found that keyword that you're going to aim at, what do you then do? Well, you then put it into the title of your page you're writing about. You mention it throughout the page naturally. And you may want to use a plugin such as Yoast or All In SEO, and they will then show you how it'll appear, how often it naturally appears as well. So here I have an article on what is EAT, which we'll come on to in a moment. That's part of our checklist. But if you notice, if I take that, which is my main keyword, it's at the beginning of the title of the H1 tag as well. And if I was then to search for that, so if I do Control F and that comes up for a search, and you notice then it appears six times. So it appears there at the top, it appears here, it appears in the main sentence as well, the opening sentence. And again, you want to get it to appear in H1, H2 tags. So this is regarding the video. And again, it probably appears down the page here as well. What is SEO in Google, the authority video. And maybe one more time here as well. And what it's doing in effect is it's just being used naturally throughout the article. The article is about EAT. You'll see that there's images. Google can understand what the image is about as well. And you can see it's, even though what is EAT SEO, this just appears what is EAT as well. So another natural way of doing it. But this article is all about EAT. So if you want to know more about that, we'll come back to this article in a moment. But that's just how you would make sure that you would include a key phrase naturally, not overly. You'd perhaps add it to an image as well. So you might have the alt tag on the image. And you always want one H1 tag that includes your keywords. But if you did stuff it with keywords and it wasn't useful, then people won't spend time on the page. That gives a signal to Google that there's information on this page that isn't helpful. And just think back to the last time that you searched for an item. You wanted to find an article that was going to be helpful or a video that was helpful. So think in terms of what would be useful for the customer. Don't think in terms of using keywords purely for the search engine optimization. And that is how you do SEO on our checklist when it comes to keywords. And as you can see here, Google actually gives guidelines for real people to go to your website and to see how they rank it. Here, for instance, in the guidelines, this is the search quality guidelines that Google representatives have. And it just shows you as well, they're looking to see and understand. So if they did a search for, say, Apple, is it the computer company? Is it a fruit? Is it the person's name? Is it a city? If they do a search for Mercury, is it the planet? Is it a chemical element? Is it the car brand? Is it an insurance company? They're trying to get context all the time by using humans to give that context back to the search engine. So if you're wanting to do search engine optimization, you have to have in mind there's a human element now that's being used. So if you want to know more about keywords, then there's a video here that will help you to jump ahead and understand keywords in more depth. Now the next area is links. Now, links are often debated. Some people think you should go out and get links. Others think that you should hold back and allow people just to link to you naturally. So you may have your view. But the point is, if you've written a well-researched article, it's got great information on, maybe some infographics and a video, people will want to link through to it. That just naturally happens. And Google uses that because, in effect, link is like a vote. And we've explained before in previous videos how link juice works. In effect, authoritative websites, if they link through to your article, you will grow in authority. So checking your domain authority, checking the authority of the websites that are linking through to you, and attracting authoritative websites to link to you is all part of the SEO checklist. And so what you may want to do is you may want to look at what your competitor is doing regarding its link strategy. It could be it's getting links from good indexes and citations that you haven't considered. It could be just a case of looking at your links and seeing where is your authority coming from and maybe reaching out to them a bit more. But ideally, you want it to be on a natural basis because that will give you a long-term growth in the search engine optimization. And you can go to Uber Suggest here and type in your website or your competitor's website, and it will give you your domain authority and it will show you where your links are coming from. And you can have all sorts of other tools. Ahrefs do a free tool that tells you when new domain authorities link through to you as well. So my link strategy has always been produce great content and people will link through to you. And that seems to work for me. It does require work, but it does get the long-term benefits. So the next part of our checklist is called EAT. And as you can see here, it's divided up into three sections. And these three sections are very much spoken of for Google's guidelines for humans to look at a website. And they're looking to see, does it have expertise? Does it have authority? Is it trustworthy? And the search engine's algorithm itself can't really work that out without human intervention. And that's why everything should be considered on a human basis, because real humans are ranking websites too with Google's help. So what actually is Google looking for? And how can we tick to make sure we have an expertise, for example? Well, to be an expert, you've got to show that you know what you're talking about in your articles, in your videos, in your infographic, whatever content you're producing that the person sees, they need to feel they can trust it, that it's well-researched, that it's honest, that it's informative, and it's original. Remember, Google knows if you've taken or copied anyone else's article. So make sure it's original and useful. And that will then give you a ranking and expertise and you can get a tick there. So what about authoritativeness? Again, it's quite difficult to decide how you can rank in authority. Time is often to do with authority. Also, the reviews that you receive and how you're perceived from other indexes, other authorities too. If they see you as the authority to turn to, then that gives off an authority ranking. So what can you do to be authoritative? Well, collect reviews. Google Business Profile is very good at offering reviews, but it's not just there. If you think of LinkedIn, if you think of Facebook, maybe even if you go to other Checkatrade, Yale, whatever it is that's local to you, getting authority by getting good ratings, reviews, rankings, all help build your authority. And the third area we want to tick is trustworthiness. But again, trust takes time to build. But for instance, if you've got an e-commerce shop, do you use the SSL certificate? So do people that put in a credit card feel safe when they use your website, or do they abandon the cart because there's no security there? When they look for your website, does the link that they click through to actually provide what they've been told it's going to provide? And having videos on your website builds trust. People can see who you are. They can see the transparency of the business they're dealing with. And so as you can see in these Google guidelines there, that again, if someone's wanting to buy a phone, they go to Google, but Google wants the person that they then serve up as an advert or as the main website to go to, they want them to be trustworthy. So would this be trustworthy? That's the question a user is asking. If it's stuffed with keywords, if it's all talking about words that perhaps don't give trust, then it will lose in that ranking. So we've got EAT. It takes a while to build this up, but once we've got these, then we can tick these off too. Now, of course, if you want to know more about EAT, I've got a playlist here, and it takes each one of those. So whether you're interested in building expertise, authority, or trust, then pick one of these videos. Now, the next thing we want to tick is speed. So a new thing that the search engines have brought in recent times is measuring the speed. Why? Because people don't want to be waiting for ages and ages and ages for the website to load. So the search engines want it to be useful to the searcher. And so the speed of your website, particularly on a mobile, is then given a ranking. It gives a signal to Google, and Google will give you greater ranking authority if it sees that your website loads fast. So how can you know whether your website loads fast? Well, first of all, you might want to have a mobile friendly theme or use AMP, which is a useful free theme that you can add onto your website, particularly if it's a WordPress website, that Google provides a plugin to do that. And I've done a video on that if you want to know more about that. Or secondly, you can go to page speed. And here on page speed, we can see that you can put in and analyze your website, and it will then tell you how quickly it's found, what type of experience a person would have, whether it loads fast on a mobile, whether it loads fast on a desktop, and where you can improve. And if I'm honest, most websites fail quite badly. So all the time it's kind of trying to improve, get the server to load quicker, try and make scripts more efficient. And you'll find as you update your website, it will get slower. So then you have to remove plugins and make sure it's running more efficiently. So it's an ongoing challenge, really. No one ever seems to get this perfect. There are some plugins you can use as well that will speed things up, that will use a CDN, that will use other ways of building up images, optimizing images as well. So just look into some of those. I've done some videos on those. And being mobile friendly is another one that you need to tick. You really do need to have your website so it works on mobiles. And being mobile friendly isn't about, does your website appear on someone's mobile? That's often misunderstood. Being mobile friendly is it readable? Is it usable? Can I read the text? Can I click the buttons? And to have things working properly on a mobile, you need to test it first of all to see if it's mobile friendly. So again, I'll put a link down below so you can do a test on your own site. As you can see here, I've done a test and my website is mobile friendly. It was crawled. And if there are issues, you can see which parts of those issues then need to be fixed. So for more details on how you can make your website more mobile friendly, then I'll put a video here for you to go and have a look at. And the next area is, again, three of the most important areas as far as Google's concerned. So to tick these, you need to kind of understand what Google, again, is looking for through the algorithm this time. So first of all, it's looking for relevance. And these things particularly are helpful when it comes to local SEO. What's the difference between local SEO and mainstream SEO? Well, the difference is it's just particularly aimed for people that are local to you. So that's why Google Business Profile is so helpful, because it takes into account the relevancy and the other things we're going to look at in a moment. So let's first of all just consider relevancy. Just think of your content. Is it relevant? Is it up to date? Does it provide a visitor with information that's current to this year? Are the prices correct? Are the hours correct? It's all relevant to your business. If those things are outdated, then it has no relevance. And how do you communicate? Are you communicating in a way that's relevant to your customers? Do you know your customers? Do you understand your customers' needs? Are you answering their questions? When they ask a question, do they get a response straight away? This is all part of building relevancy in Google. So the second area Google's looking for is distance. So how close are you to the person that's searching for you? Well, again, you can't do anything about that. You don't know who's going to be searching next. But when it comes to local search and Google Business Profile, you'll know from this channel that you can't actually do much about how far you go beyond your locality. But location also does have an impact on how you talk. So you want to be talking about local things to your local users. For example, if I spoke about football, then I'm talking in America about soccer. So the same word has different meanings in different locations. So in that sense, you want to think in terms of speaking the language of your local community and talking about landmarks that they know about and referencing perhaps links and social events that are going on that are relevant to your locality too. That tells Google that you understand what's going on locally, and so the distance actually has an authority built in itself. And the final area that Google's ranking for is prominence. Do you stand out? Are you updating your posts? Do you have offers that are useful? Do people actually visit your business? You know, Google has a lot of ways of knowing what interaction you're having with your customers. They give reviews, they also give ratings. They also say whether they think it's expensive or not. All these things are building up whether or not you're prominent in your local area. And prominence is also about a consistency. You may have heard of the NAP. So again, are you standing out as a unique business, or are there versions of your business? You may notice Google is banning a lot of businesses that have more than one base or more than one address. Why? Because they can't be prominent when they're pretending to be something different to what they are. So I've spoken a lot about Google Business Profile, and for many of you, you've now got your businesses set up. Many of you are enjoying and seeing the amount of local traffic that's now coming through to your business website. But if you do still feel you don't know much about that, then I did do a video a while ago called Google My Business for Dummies. So head over to this, and that will just answer some of your questions that maybe you just feel you didn't want to ask, but you want to know more about it. A really useful video. So once you've now gone through this checklist, how do you know whether Google's actually found it? How do you know if it's found that page with those keywords that you've spent some time researching, writing about? You've gone through this checklist today. How do you know now whether that page gets found by Google and whether it gets authority? Well, if you head over to this video, it'll show you how you can find out whether Google has spotted your website in the last week, in the last month, and what type of authority as well it's going to give it. So I'll see you there.